The benefits of circular economy are quite clear. You see that for aluminium, the demand has sort of tripled until 2100, but that the primary input that we need for that has actually been reduced to 30% of the present level. So this is quite an achievement. And that also has consequences for the energy requirement. We've calculated that, and well, the energy requirement for the new very high-level aluminium stock is only 50% of the present one. So we will have gained an enormous energy efficiency. If we manage to increase the global recycling rates to 90% during that century, at least. And that is where we have to do things. We do have to change things in society. We'll have to change the design of products and of materials, not just technically, but also conceptually, with in mind the recyclability of that. We will have to develop new business models. We'll have to put in place infrastructure to capture all that waste and to access those urban mines. And we will have to educate people in different ways, ways that are now only, well, that are not very clear yet. And this also takes time, and probably it will take at least as long as waiting for stock saturation to happen. That means that the circular economy agenda is a huge agenda with a very long time horizon.